Hi, my name is Tiger Shroff.
Hi, I'm Ananya Pandey.
Hi, I'm Tara Sataria.
And you're watching
The Movie Moth.
So I have a story about your parents, Ananya. I don't know if I'm supposed to tell you this, but I'm shameless, so I'm going to tell you.
Please do.
So there was a tarot reader, and Chunky had gone to the tarot reader. I don't know whether your mother went first or Chunky went later. And they were like really back to back. And the tarot reader told Chunky that you're going to get married very soon.
Okay.
And Chunky said, no, I'm not dating anybody.
Hmm.
And he said, how? She said, I don't know. I know that you're getting married very soon. And she knew it at that time because Bhavna had just come to him.
Oh.
And they got married to each other. I think they met at the tarot readers when they were, one was going in and one was going out. That's it.
Wow. That's what a story.
And my story about Tiger now.
I didn't know that. Yeah.
Okay. So he was this beautiful looking child. He was really gorgeous. He's gorgeous now, but he was like, I wanted to eat him up. He was like a pudding. So we were shooting a photo shoot with Jackie. And he was very, very obstinate and jealous of anybody who was spending time with his father and wanted all the attention to himself. So they had this winding staircase and this beautiful child was sitting there like this. And then suddenly, Jackie said, I'm not shooting because my child is sulking. So, do teen photo karke Jackie ne wrap up kar diya. And he had, Jackie had a blue, very stylish car.
Yeah.
Which opened here, there, everywhere. I don't know the name. And he picked this car because he was screaming and crying and wanting rat attention. So Ayesha said, you just take him. The only thing that could calm him is if his father wrapped him like this and took him for a drive.
Yeah.
So this star, Jackie Shroff, is driving in the night because this child is throwing so much tantrums.
So cute.
I don't remember this.
So this is nostalgia. Obviously, you can't remember. You were a baby. Samaya, welcome to Movie Moth channel. Today we have three wonderful young actors who are making their release in the next week, and two of them I know their parents. The third one, who is not a part of the nepotism, I don't know her parents, but that's all right. So the minute you say nepotism, it brings a smile to everybody's face because now we can joke about it and laugh about it.
Yeah.
It's perfectly all right.
Absolutely.
So when I have to introduce myself, I say I'm a film critic, I'm an author. I'm going to ask all three of you to introduce yourself in the way you think you want to introduce and not in the way we perceive you. Let's start with you, Tara.
Oh, okay. I'm Tara Sataria. I'm making my Bollywood debut with Student of the Year 2. And I'm very, very excited about it. I've been singing and dancing and performing all my life. And,
all your life is how old?
Well, since I was 5 years old and I'm 23 now. So I'm terrible with the math, but I think
18.
How long is
18,
that?
18 years now. So I'm thrilled to be taking that forward with Student of the Year 2.
My name is Tiger Shroff and I am a product of nepotism, like mom said. And I'm trying very hard to get out of my father's shadow, but he's such a big star that it's very difficult to get out of his shadow. But my goal in life is, I have very big goals, I have very big idols like Michael Jackson and I mean, he's probably the greatest entertainer that ever lived. And like him, I'd like to be, I'd like every child in every corner of every country to know who Tiger Shroff was before I die.
Soon. Hi, I'm Ananya Pandey. I just like to say that I'm filmy to the core. So I'm basically living my dream and I'm very blessed and lucky. So I'm excited.
How did this film happen to you and what was your first reaction, Ananya?
So I'd heard about this film, but I was actually planning to go to USC or NYU. I was deciding between the two. So I was all ready to go to school or to college. But I always wanted to be an actor. Like,
you wanted to go to college?
I didn't want to go to college, but my parents were being extremely realistic. They were like, you know, if you want to audition, you can audition. And if you don't get the film, then go to college. And then once you come back, you can audition again. So I was like, okay, fine, you know, if I get the chance to audition, I'd love to audition. And if it doesn't work out, then I'll go to college. And I heard about this film, so I came in and I met Puneet and I gave an audition. I gave two actually, and they ended up liking my work. So then I didn't go to college and now I'm at St. Teresa College.
Tara?
I actually met with Karan when I was just about to graduate college, and we had this wonderful meeting at the old Dharma office, and he knew that I sang, so he said, will you sing for me, which I did, and then he said, are you interested in acting? And of course I was, and he said, we're writing Student of the Year 2, And I was so excited. He said, come into the office once you've graduated college and let's test you for it. So I did just that. And luckily they liked it. And now I'm doing student of the year too.
So, you know, Tiger, I was reading an interview of yours where you said, you know, this actually is not your forte. This movie, the kind of movie it is, and that how your forte is something else. Mm-hmm. So in a way, it's easier, isn't it? You don't have to prep for it so much.
I felt like an outsider when I first started shooting for this film, and because it's
earlier it's films have all earlier, been action.
All have been action, and all have been very sort of macho, stereotypical heroes. Here, you know, I'm just playing a normal, regular college student who could get bullied. If he gets punched, he could bleed. You know. He could cry. So that was something very alien to me. Like, how can Superman suddenly be stripped off his powers? And here I am back in school, romancing two heroines.
Have you ever been to college school?
I've never been to college, no.
School you went?
I went to school. I passed out on my 12th. Mm-hmm. And then after that, I did my first film.
Same. You have not been to college. You have been to college.
I have been to college, yes.
So, you know, I was watching the trailers and song. And the college is far from a reality. I have been to college and we never had this kind of glamorous colleges. Yeah. We didn't have this kind of girls there. We didn't have this kind of guys there. It was so down market.
Yeah. And,
so it sounds strange that you've never been to college and now you're playing the students of the year. So how do you do your research? Even if it's an unrealistic film, even if it's an over-glamorous Dharma production film, some kind of research, do you have friends you talk to?
I think for a film like this, it's just so light, and the more conversational we kept it was, it worked better for the scenes, you know. Mm. It's the more you sort of, it's not a very heavy film where you've got to really dig into the character's skin and, you know, get some extraordinary thing out. It's just, we just had fun filming and we just kept it as natural and as candid as possible. Yeah. And adding to that, the environment just added so much. Our director added so much. So in no means was this film, you know, a heavy film for us. You know, we just had a breeze, and I think that's the idea and that's what we're trying to express, is just come have a good time.
Which are the old movies that you have seen and you liked?
All of My Father's.
Okay.
Yeah.
And which is your favorite?
Parinda.
Yeah. And?
Hero, of course. And there's a long list. Hmm. I don't know if you've heard of Shivaka and Saf, but that was India's first superhero movie. Hmm. And My Father is my superhero, so it was a big high to see my father fly.
Have you seen all old films? Or only your father's?
No, I'm such a big Dharma fan. I think I've grown up on K3G, Kuch Kuch Hota Hai. So my growing up was, you know, all Dharma films. Hmm. So I'm so lucky I'm a part of Dharma films, and I Hate Love Stories was actually one of my favorites because it's so fun, it's so light. So yeah, and my dad's films, I like Aankhe. I think that's one of my favorites.
Yeah, he was very funny.
Because I love David So's films as well. Yes. Yeah.
I saw you somewhere on the social media singing an old song.
That was probably.
So I was thinking that she was not born at that time, and out of all the songs in the world,
I love the classics.
Why has she chosen this one?
In fact, I believe it's Karan's favorite song as well. I believe it's Karan's favorite song as well.
So you were singing for your producer.
Well, he and I have that in common. We love this song.
So you know, Tiger, you are for us still a debutant.
Yes.
And suddenly in this film, you're a senior. Because you are launching two new girls.
I'm not launching two new girls.
No, but it's like we say Shami Kapoor is launching the two girls because they are going to have the romantic scenes or whatever scenes.
Sure, okay.
We don't know which heroine comes with you in the end or what happens. So it reminds me of an incident when Hrithik Roshan was very new and he was at a public event and there was Rani Mukherjee and the crowd was so hysterical on seeing Hrithik. And they said, Hrithik, dance karke dikhao. So Hrithik looked at Rani and he said, kya karo? So Rani said, kar le. Huh? So later on, I think his father said, why did you dance at that event? So he said, maine Rani se pucha, because Rani was senior. Rani ko kuch malum nahi hai, Rani ne bola, kar do. To aisa kuch hua tha kya? Ke, you know now, you are the senior most, you to make the decisions, these kids are asking you.
Not really, you know, they just feel, they don't feel like newcomers, they feel very...
they don't seek your advice, these girls?
Very rarely.
Super confident.
They're very confident. I think they've really prepared a lot to get here, and you know, I don't want to take any of their credit or, you know, say that I told them to do this or that. I mean, they're all, both of them are self-made, and you can, if anyone to credit, then it's probably our director Puneet or our producer Karan.
But asking you two, that when you were doing your first scene, with Tiger or without Tiger, what was it like? You can take a start.
Well, actually, the first day of shoot was our song, which releases soon, and it was so amazing. Yes, Ananya's in the song as well, and it was so exciting and nerve-wracking in a way. But I remember we were dancing together, and I sprained my ankle a little bit, and I was a bit scared because it was I think our first shot together, and Tiger was so sweet. He just held my foot and put it up on the chair next to me. He said, "Don't worry about anything," and he started massaging it so sweetly for me. So that was our first experience together, and instantly I was like, "Okay, he's so sweet and warm and considerate." And he just took. I mean, I was excited, and we'd been prepping for the song for so long, so it was so nice to actually begin it, and he was so sweet about what happened.
And you?
I think Tiger and I, we've always been comfortable around each other. I don't know, from the start only, I never felt like, you know, I was working with someone who was superior to me. I always felt like we were friends from the start, and my very first part in the song, I had to like elbow him and push him because that's my character in the film, she's like that. So I think from the start, if I had so many reservations that, oh, you know, he's Tiger and I can't push him, I feel like I wouldn't be able to perform. But he never made me feel like that. I think he's so humble, he's so down to earth. Yeah. If he'll just sit on the floor, he'll just sit anywhere, he'll, you know, just do his own thing. So I think that's a lot of credit, give a lot of credit to him, because he's never made us feel inferior in any way.
How was it with you and Tara? Because, you know, you're two girls competing for attention, space in the film. It's all okay to say that everything is fine, but there must be so many undercurrents and so many mixed emotions. He's in a safe zone.
No,
you can be honest and tell, because it's all right.
I think
I'm old enough to be your
No, so I think with us, like, we're not, you know, going to be all flowery and say, oh, we were like best friends. But I feel like because we all became like a family, obviously there's some, like, everyone fights and everyone has.
We have these very intriguing sisterly arguments. But then in 5 minutes, just like how sisters, you know, function, we'll be completely normal with each other and cuddling each other and things like that. So I think it's a really interesting relationship.
And I feel like because we spent like 45 days together from the start, we went to Mussoorie and we didn't have our own families or our friends.
Practically lived together.
Yeah, we practically were sharing a room half of the time. So I think it's impossible to not become family. And every family has their fights, their ups and downs, their problems with each other. But I think whenever we meet after a long time, it's always love, and it'll always be like
always
that for everyone in the film. Yeah.
So Tiger, every film and in every filmmaker, the experience teaches you something. It enriches you as an actor. What are you learning from every experience?
You know, the more you do something, the more...
The better you do it.
I guess if you could say better, I would say the more aware you become of things.
Okay.
And for example, what I've learned from this film is to sort of... it's added another dimension to me. It's opened me up. You know, my vision is a little... I can see further and I can see clearer now. So I've sort of let loose a lot more than... the past now,
So with all the action films that you did, and this is a Dharma film that you're doing, it's the canvas is different, the narrative will be different. What do you want to do now? Now you are getting a choice of both.
Well, I'm already doing a film with Hrithik sir next, and I'm almost done with that film as well. And then I get into Baagi 3. So I'm sort of still, you know, treading in my zone, if you may. And I'm happy doing what I'm doing, because the films I do serve pan-India. It doesn't serve a niche audience. So I think my goal, you know, is to just entertain and serve the majority rather than just a certain bunch.
Do you feel, Ananya, that because it was Alia in the first one, and she really made an impact, you kind of, without realizing, want to emulate her?
I think Alia is my biggest inspiration, and she's my idol, and I've always said that. I really look up to her, and the fact that when she came in, she was so young and she was so raw. She never claimed to be perfect from the start, and I think people have seen her grow. So in Student, she was so raw, she was so fresh, and then they saw her in Highway, Two States. So I think people have really seen her grow. So I don't think I'd like to emulate her or copy her in any way, but similarly, I'd like people to see me grow. Like, I'm not claiming to be perfect as well. I'm young, I'm new, I'm learning. So I want people to watch me grow as they've watched Alia grow.
And you, Tara, you know, she did the dance in the first one, Radha.
Yeah.
And because you're a dancer, do you have a dance like that in this one?
We actually just recently filmed our last song, which was like a big rap party for our film, which was Mumbai Dilli Diya Kuniya, which is the song that just released very recently. That was, I feel like, it was
Radha.
So much like our road to Radha, in a way, whether it was the costumes, the way we danced. Just the style of the song, I think, was so much like Radha. So we were really looking forward to that, actually. All
we begged
three of
for
us,
it, yeah.
We were like, please let us have this one Indian Dharma song. And it happened. So
you made a statement that when you had to shoot with Alia, you were a little anxious, the dance. What were your feelings when you were going to dance with her?
It was the first time I was working with Alia, and her being who she is in all her glory. I was like, yeah, I can't let her down, and I have to give my best so I can, you know, match her frame for frame. And for me, that was the challenge. And she kept saying, you know, that, Tiger, I don't know how I'm gonna match up to you and this and that, the way you dance. But I think that was all one big natak. And when she performed, then, you know, I came to know that, yeah, she's sort of was just playing me. And she did fantastic.
If I have to ask you, normally it's the journalist's turn to ask questions, but if I have to ask you to take the baton and ask Tiger whatever you want to ask, which otherwise you're not allowed to ask.
Allowed to ask?
Allowed. Tab tak aap soch lo, Tara.
Soch rahi
hoon. What do you want to know about them that you have not asked them so far?
What's your biggest lesson from this film? Like, not in a good, like in a negative way.
In a negative way?
Yeah. Like, what would you like want to change now that...
Okay, I'm surprised by your question. I thought you would ask him about...
Personal?
I know. Girlfriend or something.
That I know.
Okay.
She knows everything.
Yeah. Okay. I ask him personal questions otherwise, so now I'm being very professional.
Well, I would want to change the accident you had on set.
That's a good one.
A
very good one.
That's so sensitive.
Yeah.
What about you, Tara?
I feel like I know all the answers, so I'm trying to think of something that I don't know.
Some scene which they did that you want to ask, how they prepared?
Well, I mean, if there's one thing you could... I feel like I know what you say. If there's one thing you could change about our film, anything at all, what would that be?
The film, like what's
going to
be
boring and say absolutely nothing.
No, I was going to genuinely give you an answer. Mm-hmm. One thing that I'd like to change about our film, I'm not going to give you the reason, but during the climax action sequence, I sort of got into an argument with my director, our director, and I wish I could change that and not argue with him.
Oh, good one too. Yeah.
You wanna ask us anything?
Oh. Ah, okay. Something personal, controversial, or
you can do whatever you want.
You can say whatever you want.
Whatever.
Preferably not controversial would be nice.
You can even ask me if you want. Not that there is anything to know about me.
Who should I start with?
Whoever you want.
Okay. Who wants to go first?
Ask me.
Kitna democratic hai, dekho.
Ask me.
I'll go first.
You know, Tiger, you are becoming like Aamir Khan. You cannot take so much space and time.
Well, that's a good thing. Wow.
Compliment.
Thank you.
It's very positive.
What is your biggest fear?
In life.
What are you scared of? What are you scared of most?
I think failing would be a big fear because, or disappointing my father, because I don't want to, like, you know, because he's kind of creating like a legacy or whatever which I'm supposed to take forward. So I don't want to tarnish that in any way. So I think not being accepted by people would be a big fear for me.
Okay.
I'm very scared of that. Because I'm a people's person. Like, I love like making everyone around me happy. So if I don't do that, I get very like anxious.
Your father is like that too.
Yeah, exactly.
Outside of your family, who's the most important person in your life?
Outside of my family?
Yeah.
Ooh, that's a tricky one. So that's a tough one.
Not so tricky.
So many.
It should come like this.
Yeah, the only thing that comes to my mind
despite you saying outside of my family, it's still inside my family because I have a twin sister and she is the single most important.
That's why I said outside your family.
But
I knew that also.
But then, I mean, I'm a very reserved person.
Okay,
I don't have
very
many.
Who's somebody you really get along with in the industry? Who is one person that you would, interact with or probably message every day or something?
I'm looking right at him, too.
Really?
We talk so much, not every day, but we talk so much.
You're the one, yeah, of course.
Now you worked with her, tell me something where she can improve herself.
Oh yes.
As a person and as an actor.
She's got immense confidence too soon in her life. And I think it's a good thing and it's a bad thing because people may perceive that as something else. So I would tell her to internalize that confidence, and I would want her to sort of not come across so prim and proper all the time, so alert and always calculating on what to say and what not to say, and just be yourself, because I think each one of y'all are special in your own way, and I think it's important that that individuality comes across.
That's very mature.
Thank
you. That's quite an answer.
Much beyond your age?
Yes.
So now what is it that you think that he should improve, or that some plus or minus of Tiger?
I've always told him, I think he gets too stuck up on detail and just being perfect all the time, and sometimes he should just let go and just let other people handle it and just not be like obsessive over detail.
Okay. You?
I actually love his obsession with certain things. I think it's what makes him who he is. I do think that he's already working on the things that a lot of people told him maybe he should work on. He's already working on all of them, and he's completely evolved and changed in the last year that we've known him. So I think he's already on it.
Great. So I wish all three of you great luck.
Thank you.
And my
much.
Blessings are there.
Thank
for
you so
student
much.
Of the year. And I'll tell you what I thought of the film when I see it.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.